Hi, my name is Kevin, Product Experience Specialist here at Facebook. Thank you all so much for joining us today to learn more about the brand new Oculus Quest 2 that was announced at Facebook Connect. The Oculus Quest 2 starts at $299 for the 64 gig, as well as $399 for the 256 gig. Right now, if you head over to our oculus.com website, you can do your pre-orders, and in stores, you can purchase October 13th. The Oculus Quest 2 features our brand new Qualcomm Snapdragon XR2 platform processor, as well as 6 gigs of RAM. In terms of display, the Oculus Quest 2 has 50% more resolution than the original Quest. Also to note, it has an LCD display that gives you nearly an output of 2K resolution per eye. In terms of design, the Oculus Quest 2 is 10% lighter than the original Quest. Also, with the controllers, we've redesigned it so that it's more comfortable, as well as a dedicated spot to rest your thumbs. The Oculus Quest 2 is also compatible with the Oculus Link cable so that you can still access your PC VR games. And in terms of setup, it's easy. All you need is your iOS or Android device to start your device. No PC required. Now let's talk about the accessories. The Oculus Quest 2 comes with a soft strap. But if you're a gamer like me, I recommend the Elite strap with the battery to give you more hours in game. The Oculus Quest 2 is our all-in-one gaming headset. There's so many amazing AAA games coming out soon with the Oculus Quest 2. I'm gonna hand it off to Saori, who's gonna talk about some of her favorite games and experiences inside the headset.
Hi everyone, my name is Saori, and I'm a product experience specialist for Facebook. With all the incredible advancements of the new Oculus Quest 2, with Qualcomm Snapdragon XR2 processor, 6 GB of memory, and 50% increase in display resolution, you will experience next-level VR like never before. Today, we will be taking a test drive on some of our favorite VR titles. So, let's get into the headset. When wearing your headset, always make sure to tighten the soft straps in the back and on top. And with the touch controllers, always secure your safety lanyards. And before you get into any games, always be sure to establish your guardian boundary. We always recommend a space of over 6.5 feet by 6.5 feet, and make sure you're clear of any items or furniture around you. So now that you're all set, let's get into our first game. The first content we're going to introduce to you is First Steps. First Steps is an introductory VR content that'll help you familiarize yourself with the touch controllers. Here we have a couple items. We can grab them, play with them, throw them around, play with ping pong balls, throw some paper airplanes, and even launch some rockets. And to make a fist, you have to press the grip button as well as the trigger button. And you can even punch balls like this.
Hey, so hurry. Now that you learned the controls, let's jump into Robo Recall.
Yes. Robo Recall is one of my favorite games. Here's the main menu. And what's also awesome about this game is that you have guns equipped onto your body. So you will reach down to grab that pistol, and for shotguns as well. And we will be teleporting using the thumbsticks. And let's get started on a mission.
A hotspot is erupting. Hold for teleport, age of 34.
And look how beautiful the graphics are here.
And constructed a robo relay to pacify the area.
You will see your hands in game, and if you reach down, you will see the guns. And all you have to do is equip them using the grip button.
It burns.
And once you're done with the gun, you can even throw it at them as well. And catch some of their items.
Not good, not good. Blue screen. Ow, ow, ow. Service with a smile.
That'll teach him to think.
It burns.
So you can catch these bullets and throw them back.
You
can even punch them as well. Turn to sender.
So it looks like you're having way too much fun here at Robo Recall. Let's jump into that hand tracking with the Oculus Quest 2.
Absolutely. Hand tracking is one of our newest features that we're super excited to talk to you about today. Hand tracking allows you to control the game even without a touch controller. So I'm going to put this down. And we are going to be playing a game called The Curious Tale of the Stolen Pets. And hand tracking allows you to control the game entirely with just your bare hands. This game is a cause and effect puzzle game where you search for stolen pets within a map. If you like to sit down, relax, and solve some puzzles while taking your time, this is the game for you. So to select, you are going to point and hold. If you're an animal lover like me, you're gonna love this game. It's super adorable and it makes you feel like you're a kid again. We will try this map right here. And the main controls of this game is a pinching and dragging motion. And as you can see, here's the map.
For another visit to the summer.
And your hands are still there. You can pinch and drag. And look around for hints and clues. You can even interact with them. You can also pick up items. And play around with them. Can even interact with this guy right here. Isn't that adorable? Now, that's all the time we have for today. I'm gonna be passing it back to Kevin for some questions.
All right, let's jump into the questions now. First question, are all the new game titles coming to the Quest and the Quest 2? And yes, as of right now, all the new game titles are coming to the Quest and the Quest 2 devices. Will any game titles only work on the Quest 2? Some of our highest-end applications in the future will be able to leverage the extra power of the Quest 2 and exclusive to that device. But we do expect that most of the software will ship for both devices right now. Will I have to repurchase any of the Quest or Quest 2 compatible titles onto my new device? And the answer is no, because any titles that you purchased already, you will also own for the Quest 2. Next question, do you plan to stop shipping Rift S software updates? And do you also plan to stop accepting Rift app submissions? The answer is no. We haven't announced any changes to the Rift support nor to the Rift store. Where can I buy the Oculus Quest 2? The Oculus Quest 2 will be sold in over 22 countries, including for the first time in retail locations in Japan. Also available on oculus.com in retail locations in the US, Canada, UK, and France. Again, I want to recommend going onto your oculus.com website where we have our full list of where you can purchase your device. Will the newly designed touch controllers work for the Quest or Rift S? No, they're only compatible with the Quest 2. The next question, about how many games will be able to store on each size of the Quest 2? It all depends on the size of the game itself. Most of our current titles are less than 4 gigs, with a few exceptions beyond that. The next question is, what is the battery life of the Quest 2? Again, it all depends on the content that you're playing, but you should expect between 2 to 3 hours based on your gameplay. And here I do want to recommend the Elite Strat with battery that will give you a few extra hours in your headset. Will the same prescription lenses that were recommended for Quest also work with the Quest 2? Yes, it does. The next question, does the Quest 2 feature an IPD adjustment? Yes, it does. It features a really simple built-in IP adjustment mechanism with 3 settings, 58, 63, and 68mm. The next question is, what is the difference between the LCD and the OLED? With the LCD display, it provides a higher resolution visuals that we know that's important to our users. The Oculus Quest 2 gives you 50% more resolution than the original Quest. Thank you all so much for joining. My name is Kevin, and once again, if you have any questions, please feel free to go to our Oculus.com website, where you can also make your pre-order. Have a good day.